السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله رب العالمين، صلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، أما بعد، الحمد لله على كل حال. بارك الله فيك وفيكم أجمعين. طيب، today إن شاء الله we continue. We said that chapter 1 and the rest of chapters are used to express different meanings along with what the root words give as a meaning. So the root word, it has a meaning. It goes back to a meaning. Then you can fashion this meaning with another meaning. So you give the word another meaning just by adding a letter. You combine another meaning to the word, another meaning to its meaning, just by adding a letter or two or three. And this is what we did in Af'ala and what we're going to do in all the chapters. So all the coming chapters, we're going to stop at each chapter and speak about some of the meanings used for that chapter, or some of the meanings which that chapter is used for. واضح بارك الله فيكم. So we took one of the meanings, or you could say one of the objectives as to why chapter one is formed, is to imply what making. واضح. And this we called التعديه. التعديه. And التعديه is basically crossing over the verb, meaning making it transitive. التعديه. Now we wrote it on the board last time. التعديه. Crossing over the verb, making it transitive, including it the meaning of making. واضح؟ That's the first one that we have taken. What's the second one that we have given you? Huh? What's the second one? No, before al-izala. Did we give you al-izala right after the first one? طيب الإزالة. الإزالة. What is الإزالة? الإزالة is removal. Is removal. Okay? Meaning that this chapter is formed to express, yani one of the meanings why it's formed, is to express removing from the receiver the meaning which the verb is taken from. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. طيب جزاك الله خيرا. واضح؟ وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. To express removing from the receiver the meaning which the verb is taken from. Okay? So here we have a verb. See, this is the logical order of any sentence. Okay? This that I'm about to teach you now, it has to do with grammar now. Okay? In grammar, the logical order, okay, of the sentence is starting with the verb, then the doer, then the receiver. Okay? So you say, for example, you say ضرب زيد عن بكر, for example, or امرأة. ضرب زيد عمرا. Even though what I'm giving you here is not directly related to صرف, but it helps you a bit. ضرب زيد عمرا. ضرب زيد عمرا. What does it mean? زيد hit عمر. So there is a hitting that took place. And the hitting came from who? From Zayd. Zayd is the doer. And it fell on who? On Amr. Zayd is the receiver. Zayd is the receiver. Okay? This is the logical order of the verbal sentence. What is the verbal sentence? Zayd is the doer. Amr is the receiver. What did we say? We said the opposite. By mistake. So Zayd is the doer. Yadi Zayd is the one from whom the hitting came. And Amr is the one on whom the hitting fell. So Zayd is the doer and Amr is the receiver. Tayyib? Well, that's the order. The order is there on the board. Now you recognize the verb because that's the first letter which is done, the first word which is written. Then naturally, the natural logical order is this, even in English, okay, the order, the doer comes before the receiver, even though the verb comes after the doer, okay, and not before in English. So ضرب زيد عمرا, زيد هيك عمر. واضح. Now, what do you notice that at the end of the doer, the one doing the act, what haraka is there? There's a dhamma. This is by default. By default, every doer will have a dhamma at its end. This is by default. Okay? And the receiver, by default, has a fatha at the end. Okay? That's why it was given a dhamma and a fatha. The doer is given a dhamma, every doer is given a dhamma, and every receiver is given a fatha. To show the difference and distinguish between the one who did the act and the one who received it. Understand? Barakallahu fikum. طيب. Here, شكا شكا شكا. What does it mean? شكا means complained. Shaka means complained. Shaka is originally what? Shakawa? How did you know? Why shouldn't it be shakaya? Very good, because the alif is standing. If the last alif is standing, then what? Then it means that it is originally what? A waw. Okay? In another dialect with a ya. Okay. So shaka. Now, shaka is what? Is complained. Is complained. If you wanted to imply removing the complaining. If you wanted to express removing the complaining. You say, for example, here, Shaka Zaidun. Shaka Zaidun. No, because we're talking about verbs here. La is a preposition. Here, you're not allowed to use any prepositions because here, not allowed, not in the sense that you can't. No, not allowed in this because it's not what you're learning here. You're not learning to affirm or to negate, or you're not learning to negate by by what? By adding a word. No, we want you to build the verb in another way, which includes the verb, the meaning removing, the meaning of removing. Understood? So you are to forget here something called using a preposition here. Yani, it's like cheating, yani, here, because that's not what you're learning. So shaka Zaidun, Zaid complained. Now you want to express that what? That Zaid removed the complaining of someone else. And what does it mean to remove one's complaint? Huh? Yes, ahsante, to solve it. Okay? Yes, to solve it, to solve the problem, to solve his problem. Okay? Or to remove his complaining. Maybe his is not a real problem. But it's just a complaining that is not a problem to be solved. Wadih? But it is something to be corrected. So, you say, you bring it on the scale of af'ala. You bring it on the scale of af'ala. Yani you turn shaka into af'ala. You turn shaka into af'ala. So how do you say it? Huh? You say ash ka. You just add the hamza, that's all. I'll make it easy for you. Just add the hamza. Okay? Yani don't return any letter to its original state. You say ash ka. But here, we have a principle for you. If the waw fell fourth place. If the waw fell four place or more, you turn it to a ya. Then you turn it to an alif. Okay? So this is how they write ashka. This is every waw. Every waw when it is fourth place or more, fourth, fifth, sixth, okay, it is turned to a ya, then from a ya to an alif. Take it as a principle. No, of course. Everywhere, like we said, in general, barakallahu feek. Wadih? You didn't understand. The waw, when it comes a fourth letter or a fifth letter, يعني when the word ends with a waw. When it ends with a waw. And that waw is fourth place or more. Then you turn that waw to a ya. يعني you treat it as if it is a ya. يعني it is a ya. You turn it into a ya. And then you apply the necessary. يعني for example, أشكى is أشكيا. After turning the waw to a ya. And then you turn the ya into an alif. Saying أشكى. Understand? Everyone. It falls fourth place. Okay? Fourth place. It's turned to a ya. Then it turns to whatever it could be turned to. But first of all, turn it to a ya. Understand? Huh? This is on your in the four letter verb. I didn't understand the question. You mean only? Only in the four letter verb, you mean? Huh? No. This is whenever the waw, I told you it's general. General principle. Whenever the waw is fourth or more, I said. Yani fourth, fifth, sixth. Okay? That's a question at the end, inshallah. Okay, understood this principle? This principle is understood? Okay. So you say, Ashka Zaydun Amra. Ashka Zaydun Amra. What does that mean, Ashka Zayd al-Amra? That means Zayd removed what? Amr's complaint. Or Amr's complaining. Wadih? In the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they said, Shakawna ila Rasulillah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَلَمْ يُشْكِنَا يُشْكِنَا شَكَوْنَا إِلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ فَلَمْ يُشْكِنَا. See the difference between the three-letter verb شَكَى شَكَوْنَا. What does شَكَوْنَا mean? We complained, yes. But the second one is that you, yushki. Yushki. No, not he complains. Yushki. Yeah, we don't say solve our problem because he solved their problem by not يعني, responding to that complaint. واضح? Because that complaint is not in its place. فَلَمْ يُشْكِنَا يُشْكِي. It's originally يُشْكِي like this. يُشْكِي. It's with a dhamma. It's not yashki. Yes. He did not. He did not. Lam yushki. No, barakallahu fiki. Don't say he did not solve a problem. هذا لا يليق يعني this is not suitable to the prophetic state لم يشكنا يعني لم يزل شكوانا he did not remove our complaint يعني is every complaint in its place huh no واضح so the complaint that is not in its place it is ignored Or the person is advised. طيب. So فلنعم لم يشكي 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 is from which verb? From شكا? Is يشكي from شكا? No, it's not from شكا. أيوة أحسنتي. أشكى. آه. What happened to the revision? Why did we say it is from Ashka? Huh? How did we know it is from Ashka? Because there's a Dhamma on the Ya, not a Fatha. Huh? So the Dhamma tells you that that it is a 3 plus 1 verb. Doesn't it? Akhraja. What's the مضارع of أخرج؟ يخرج أو يخرج؟ يخرج. So you have to always put in mind, get used to it, that whenever the letter of the مضارع has a ضمة and the verb is active, then it is from a 3 plus 1 verb. Understand? Never forget this point. All right? Whenever, I'll say it again, whenever the verb, whenever the mudari' has a dhamma on the letter of the mudari' and the verb is active, then it is a 3 plus 1 verb. Wadih? Or it is formed from a 3 plus 1 verb. Understand? So yushki, what does yushki mean regardless the sentence it is in? Huh? No, no. Active means يعني the doer is mentioned. أي نعم. He removed the complaint. نعم. He removed the complaint. So I repeat once again. Okay? We have taken before that the verb, the 3 plus 1 verb in this chapter has the Hamza dropped. Okay? This is number one. Number two, that the letter of the Mudari is given a Dhamma. The letter of the mudari' is given a dhamma instead of a fatha. And this we said only where? Where is this done only? Only in one place. Only in 3 plus 1 verbs. Not only in bab al-if'al. In all 3 plus 1 verbs. يُفْعِلُ and يُفَعِّلُ and يُفَاعِلُ. واضح بارك الله فيكم. So the mudari' of ashka is yushki, not yashki. واضح? No. Regardless the meaning you used it for, whether you used it for ta'diyah, or you used it for al-izana, or any of the meanings for which you use the first chapter, that doesn't matter. Because the letter of the mudari' taking a dhamma, it's not a matter of meaning. Okay? It's just a matter of wording, of how to write the word. Yeah, I'm excused. واضح؟ طيب. Now, يشكي, it means he removes, جزاك الله خيرا, the complaint, the complaining. He removes the complaining. Huh? Where the lettering came from. What lettering? The word by itself, brother Rizq. Yani by itself. Yushki by itself means that. Understand? Now, lam yushki, lam is used to negate. Lam is used to negate. Lam yushki, huh. What does it mean, lam? Lam yushki. Huh. Yes, he did not remove the complaining. واضح؟ Of course, lam, when it enters, when it precedes the verb, it removes its end if its end was harfu izla. This is a even though it's a grammatical issue, but it is somewhat necessary to make you understand. Okay? Lam, if it precedes the verb, it drops the last letter if the last letter was harf wa illa. Wabih? So, see, we're gonna drop that letter. فَلَمْ يُشْكِي لَمْ يُشْكِنَا يعني he did not remove our complaining. Okay? Yes, it is present tense. The verb is present tense. But the verb sometimes has things joined to it which changes its time frame. Lam is one of them. Lam, when it enters the verb, it changes its time to the past instead of the what? Instead of the present. Okay? Hey now. Like لم يكن الله ليغفر لهم. يعني Allah was not to forgive them. Okay? Understood? So شكونا إلى رسول الله. We complained to the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he did not remove our complaint. واضح؟ نعم. يعني that was not to happen. Okay? Understood? So this is one of the meanings. All right, al-izala. This is al-izala. We move to the next meaning. Please try to keep the questions at the end, inshallah, as we have agreed, inshallah. Okay, I'm going to answer this one, but please be reminded that all questions are to be at the end. The alif maqsura is put. As we said, it follows the same principle. If the waw comes fourth in place or more, it is changed into a ya. Okay? Yani, exchange it with a ya. That's all. And then do whatever you want with it. Which, yani. The other two examples for you to work with, inshallah. Wabe? Yani, you understood them? The other two examples? The other two examples that we gave you, you understood them? Everyone understood them? Of course, aqsata means removed, or ajara. Ajara means removed the oppression. So does aqsata. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَمَنْ أَقْسَطَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ تَحَرَّوْ رَشَدًا أليس كذلك؟ Ah. Fine, let us do it. طيب, inshallah. فَمَنْ أَقْسَطَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ تَحَرَّوْ إيش؟ ولا فَمَنْ أَسْلَمَ هَذَا؟ وأما نعم, هذا فَمَنْ أَسْلَمَ عفوا, فَمَنْ أَسْلَمَ فَأُولَٰئِكَ تَحَرَّوْ رَشَدًا. There is actually an example I gave you in the hadith. That was a hadith, by the way, the example that I gave you last time, it was a hadith. Yeah. The example, سبعة يظلهم الله في ظل عرشه يوم القيامة إمام يقسط سبعة سبعة يظلهم سبعة يظلهم الله في ظل عرشه في ظل عرشه يوم القيامة. Then he mentioned one of them, إمام يقصد. إمام يقصد سبعة. What does that mean? Yeah, translate for me, please. سبعة. Anyone knows what سبعة means? Seven. سبعة يعني seven people. There are seven types of people. Yudhillu. Do yudhillu alone. What does yudhillu came from? Which verb? It's from adhalla. Adhalla. Yani, in general, you say it came from a 3+1 verb. How do you know? Yes, because there is a dhamma on the letter of the mudari', and that is only done with the 3+1 verb. Simple, that's simple answer, okay? Yani, even if you did not know how to say the original word, okay, just by looking at the letter of the mudari', and you see that dhamma, you say that's from a 3+1 verb. Are you? Now, try to bring that narration, because this narration, it's does not have these very words, but these very words are a certain narration. Huh? It's better that you find that one. طيب. على كل حال. سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمْ يعني الله will shade them. يُظِلُّهُمْ Seven whom Allah shades. يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ Let me ask you sort of an off-topic question, but it is related. Where is the doer of يُظِلُّ? How did you know? How did you know? أحسنتي because of the dhamma on the last letter. Okay? As we have taught you. Seven whom Allah shades in fi dhilli the shade of his throne. Dhilli arshihi. His throne. Arshihi. His throne. يوم القيامة يعني on the day of judgment واضح؟ نعم نعم just إن شاء الله search in the الدورة السنية blessed admin and you will find it just write إمام يقصد and you will find it you will find that narration إن شاء الله نعم يوم القيامة إمام يقسط ها an imam يعني a ruler one in authority a leader imam means leader a leader of course يعني a legal leader not just anyone carrying the weapon and saying he's a leader ليس كذلك Otherwise, everyone can be a leader like that. And it could be chaos. واضح? إمام يقسط. يقسط means what? يقسط means... أحسنتي بارك الله فيك. He removes the oppression. And removing the oppression is doing what? Is establishing justice. Is establishing justice. واضح? That's what it means. Okay? Because the original verb, okay, or let's say the three-letter verb is قَصَطَ. قسط and قسط means the opposite يعني قسط will mean what قسط will mean he oppressed قسط will mean he oppressed it's a verb action واضح there's a beautiful يعني I want to stop here and explain to you a beautiful what, يعني a beautiful answer that Sheikh Ibn Baz رحمه الله تعالى had given to a question. And this question, Sheikh Ibn Baz رحمه الله تعالى solved it by clarifying a purely morphological issue, يعني a purely صرف issue. Which goes to show you that all of our senior scholars are well versed in those Arabic sciences. Okay. So Sheikh Ibn Baz was asked to what seems to be a contradiction between two verses. Okay. The verse لا يأكله
لا
ولا طعام إلا من غسلين. ولا طعام إلا من غسلين. Then he said, لَا يَأْكُلُهُ No, not this one. نعم, عفوا. وَأَمَّا الْقَاسِطُونَ فكانوا لجهنم حطبا أليس كذلك؟ وأما القاسطون فكانوا لجهنم حطبا حطبا This is a verse. Okay. And in another verse, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ إن الله يحب المقسطين choose one, no problem. Anyone choose it. أم وأما القاسطون فكانوا لجهنم حطبا إن الله يحب المقسطين huh? It seems outwardly to hear to he who has no knowledge of sarf that it is a contradiction because here وأما القاسطون فَكَانُوا لِجَهَنَّمَ حَطَبًا What does it mean? يعني what does كَانُوا لِجَهَنَّمَ حَطَبًا mean? They were what to the hellfire? Yes. أحسنتي. Firewood. Now, they'll be fueling the hell's fire. And in this verse, the second one, the one below, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ It says that Allah loves them. يعني people think that this is the same meaning as this. قاسط قاسطون مقسطون same meaning people think it's the same meaning okay so let me give you something that is advanced in صرف that you can understand it inshallah okay and it's easy to understand because you have enough principles to understand it something that is advanced and it will come later but just to show you How much a difference the sarf can make in understanding the verses. Okay? Now, qasata. Qasata. قاسط قاسط it means what يقسط means he oppressed أيوة Okay? Now, look carefully. أقسط يقسط means what? يعني he was just. He was just. أليس كذلك؟ يعني removing the oppression is in the sense of being just. Father? يقسط. Now, in the future, you will learn something. Okay, it's a principle. Is how to build the name of the doer. And here we say the name, the noun expressing the one who did the act. It's called ismul fa'il. Okay, the noun expressing the one who did the act, this is called ismul fa'il. Okay? Now, how do you build ismul fa'il? How do you build ismul fa'il from a three-letter verb? Three-letter verb. Okay, you bring it on the scale of fa'il. Yani you turn it to the scale fa'il. That's only the three-letter verb, huh? The three-letter one. You bring it on the scale of what? Of? فاعل. Okay? So, turn قسط into the scale فاعل. How do you say it? أيوة. You say قاسط. 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 An oppressor. Okay? You with me, huh? طيب. How do you build اسم الفاعل from a four? يعني a 3+1 letter verb. Listen, I'll show you how to do it. Even not just a 3+1. 3+1 or 2 or 3. Okay? You look carefully. You exchange the ya of the mudari' with a meme. With a meme. Okay. أحسنت. What happened here? Why does it show that students are touching the board? طيب ما في بس. Okay. No, you don't do anything to the aim. You mean in the three-letter verb? Huh? If it gets a fatha, na'am, na'am. But I mean here you don't do anything. Here you don't do anything. Just keep it as it is because it's already a kasra. This is when it's not a kasra, you turn it into a kasra. Ala kulli hal. اسم الفاعل from قسط يقسط you say قاسط. But اسم الفاعل from أقسط يقسط, how do you do it? So you exchange the ya. This is in any verb. Any verb which is 3 plus 1, just exchange the letter of the mudari' with the mim. So you say muqsit. You don't say qasit. You say muqsit. Muqsit. See the difference? The same root letters are used, but this one gave the exact opposite meaning of that one. Understand? So here, al-qasitun is the exact opposite of al-muqsitin. Al-muqsitin is plural, by the way. Both of al-qasitun and al-muqsitin are plural. Qasit is singular. Muqsit is singular. Muqsitin is the plural of muqsit, and qasitun is the plural of qasit. Okay? See what happened? Totally different. So Sheikh bin Baz, he answered saying, qasit is from qasata yuqsitu, yaqsutu, which means oppressed. And muqsit, muqsitin, is from aqsata yuqsitu, which is remove the oppression. Simple. Wadih? And the person who does not know Arabic, even if he's a da'iyah, can he give that meaning? No, never. Wadih? Not even in his dreams. Wadih, barakallahu feekum. جزاك الله خيرا الله أكبر هذا جيد بارك الله فيك يلا give us the link let's put it on the board and show the students the blessed students إن شاء الله تعالى beautiful جزاك جزاكم الله خيرا There you go. Okay. This is just to give you an example, yeah, because these examples, barakallahu fikum, this is basically showing you the fruit of what you're learning and what you have learned actually. So see here, it says here, أرجو أن تتفضلوا, يعني I hope that you, يعني do us a favor, yeah. I was moving it, I was adjusting it. There we go. Says arju, I'll just remove the title, we don't need it. Says arju an tatafaddalu bil ijaba. Yani, I hope that you are, that you kindly give an answer about the following. ما الفرق بين الآيات الكريمة الآتية؟ What is the difference between the following noble verses? في الآية الخامسة عشرة, in the 15th verse from Surah Al-Jinn, Allah says, exalted is He, وَأَمَّا الْقَاسِطُونَ فَكَانُوا لِجَهَنَّمَ حَطَبًا. And in the 18th, sorry, in the 8th verse of Surah Al-Mumtahina, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. And in the 42nd verse of Surah Al-Ma'idah, فَحْكُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ بِالْقِسْطِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُقْسِطِينَ. Okay? The point is where? The point is here. Actually, we'll read the whole thing. القسط الذي أمر الله بالحكم به هو العدل. Says the قسط, which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded to judge by, is justice. والمقسطون هم أهل العدل. And المقسطون are the people of justice. في حكمهم, in their rulings, in their judgment, وفي أهليهم, and in their families. وفيما والله ولاهم الله عليهم. And in that, or in those whom Allah made them, or gave them authority over. وأقسط, see, huh. وأقسط, let me give the تشكيل as I read. Let me give the تشكيل as I read. وأقسط, and the verb أقسط, أي, means, meaning, عدل, في الحكم, means, he was just in the judgment. وأدى, and paid, الحق, the rights. Wa, and lam, did not, yajur, from jara yajuru, yani he did not oppress, he did not transgress. Amma al-qasit, as for al-qasit, as we have explained, فهو الجائر, not الجائز, this is wrong, الجائر, يعني the oppressor, الظالم, يقال, huh, see, look, يقال قسط, huh, يقسط قسطا, see, beautiful, isn't it? فهو قاسط إذا جار وظلم. ولهذا قال تعالى وأما القاسطون فكانوا لجهنم حطبا. That is why Allah said, as for القاسطون, they will be fuel for the fire. يعني الظالمين. He means the oppressing, الجائرين, the transgressing, المعتدين, the abusing, المتعدين, those who cross the limits of Allah. المتعدين لحدود الله. وهم الذين توعدهم الله. يعني those are the ones whom Allah threatened. بأن يكونوا حطبا لجهنم. That they are to be the fuel of hell. Of hell. أما المقسطون. As for المقسطون مق. مقسطون بالميم, by the mean, من أقسطوا, أقسطوا, يعني it's from the verb, من means from, He is trying to say that what? It is from the verb أقسطوا. من الرباعي. From the four-letter verb. He means by the rubai, the verb which has four letters. Ya salah. See? Purely, يعني, a sarf answer. فهؤلاء, for those are أهل العدل, the people of justice. الموفقون. المهديون, the ones who are guided. الذين يعدلون, the ones who يعني establish justice in their ruling and in their family, and whomever Allah gave authority over. ولهذا قال تعالى, and that is why Allah said, إن الله يحب المقسطين. Verily Allah loves the people of justice, the people who are upright, righteous. ولهذا جاء في الحديث الصحيح عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that is why it was recorded in the authentic hadith from the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he said, Al-Muqsituna ala manadira bin nur, yawm al-qiyamah, etc. Wadih? Questions, please. 3 minutes only for questions. What is the meaning of jara? Jara yajuru. Jara means oppressed. And azara? Azar? Our homework. Huh? Which one? Azara. I don't remember azara. Maybe you're using a letter for a different letter, yani English. Ajara, you mean maybe? Ajara. Huh? You mean maybe ajara, huh? After dal? If three plus one verbs can have meaning of making, what is meant by qist? Al-qist is al-adl. Al-qist is al-adl. Okay? Some words in Arabic can be used for opposites. And these words are called al-dad. Al-dad. Opposites. We have such words that are used for two opposites. And you can use them for this or use them for that. Understand? If three plus one verbs can have meaning, can have meaning of making or removing based on the verb types or context, based on what you want to express. If you want to use it to imply that, then that is the meaning which is meant. But is not qasata from the three-letter verb, it's masdar, qist, you mean? Na'am. But al-qist is from the abdad. Yani, it is used for two opposites. Yani, you can use it to imply justice and you can use it to imply what? To imply oppression. Na'am. Barakallahu feekum, Ustaadh. It is right to say in the principle of vowel changing into a ya, when it comes fourth place in a verb, we first change into an alif. No. We change to a ya, and then change to an alif. Understand? Ya, ayn dal ra. Adhara? We do not give adhara, barakallahu feekum. والله تعالى أعلم وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.